This program is made possible by the giving of the God-called partners of Renner Ministries.
Hello, dear friends. I'm so glad that you are with me today. Today, I have something I'm so excited to talk to you about, and that is the love of God. Oh, you say, well, I already know that God loves me. I've known that since I was 5 years old. Well, the Bible says in Ephesians chapter 3 that we might know the length, the depth, the height, the breadth of His love. So I think, friend, we can know more. The revelation can expand wider of this great love of our God to us. And that's what I want to talk to you today about. And I'm offering you a video series for those who don't want to read something. You can watch something or the study guide, which you can have, and then you can study right along with me. But I also want to offer you my book, Unstoppable, because actually, to continue to receive revelation and what God wants to show us about His love, which is His will, we've got to be unstoppable. We got to put aside that unforgiveness, fear, negative opinions of others, and keep moving forward on understanding and receiving and believing that love that God has to each one of us. Oh, I'm so excited to open this up to you today because I believe it's going to touch your heart. And if you need prayer, please let us know how we can pray for you because we are there waiting. We're waiting to answer your email, waiting to answer your phone call, and how we can pray and agree with you. And if God's done something special in your life, please let us know about that. Well, I am ready to start this wonderful study on the love of God. So stay with me, and I'm going to be right back. Well, today I want to talk to you about the love of God revealed. And I want to open it up like this, like you go to the theater and you're sitting there with the audience and you're just waiting. Maybe if it's a play, maybe it's a ballet, maybe it's an opera, whatever it is. And maybe the orchestra's there, the curtain is drawn, and you're waiting for that curtain to open up. And that's what God did. He opened the curtain. And I want to describe it to you, friend, as opening up it up little by little. And so we see the first opening of that curtain when we see Adam and Eve in the garden. And they have wonderful fellowship with God. They're naming all the animals. They love each other. Everything is so wonderful. And then Adam and Eve, you know, they sin. And God throws them out of that garden because it says that they might touch the tree of life. And they would have been lost in that condition forever. We see God's mercy right then. We see God's mercy that when they were hiding from Him and they covered themselves with leaves, God shed the first blood and covered them with the skin of animals. So we see little by little now, the curtain is opening. God has made man. Man has already messed up, but God's opening the curtain of His love. He's already showing His love. He's already showing His rescuing, saving power. Well, the next thing that happens is God gives the law. Well, the men cannot obey the law. The law is for our good, and it was for their good to protect themselves from themselves, but they couldn't obey it. So then God sent the prophets, and the prophets were wonderful. And they did amazing things, and they would bring salvation and to the people of Israel, and the enemy would not slaughter them, and God's people would continue to flourish. But the people of God would continue to stray from God. God's opening that curtain, revealing to us his great love. And the Bible says in Galatians chapter 4, verse 4, I want to read you this verse, and it says, but when the fullness of the time had come, God sent forth his son, born of a woman, born under the law. Right at the right time, God sent his son. And we see the curtain opening. And, you know, this revelation is so amazing because God loves us so much. And I showed you before that man kept messing up. Man kept sinning. Man kept rejecting God. God kept reaching out to man. And man kept rejecting him. And finally, God says, I've got to save them. I've got to get to them. I've sent my prophets. I've sent the law. I'll just come myself. You know, friend, I want to tell you something. About 6 or 7 years ago, I was just riding in a car, and I was reading in John. And for the first time in my life, it was open to me. Yes, I knew that Jesus was God and that he was God in the flesh. I knew that. You probably know that. But 6 or 7 years ago, in the back seat of that car, reading the Word of God, all of a sudden, I saw it. I saw that God Almighty, God the Creator, God, the one that's giving you breath to breathe right now. God, the one that's holding every atom and proton and neutron together in this universe to hold it together, holding it together by his word. That God that split the Red Sea, God that the people of Israel, they wanted to worship the golden calf more than they wanted to worship God. God swallowed them up. The Bible says 3,000 of them, the earth opened up and swallowed them up. That God, the God that stopped the mouth of lions for Daniel, and Daniel slept with hungry lions all night long and they didn't touch him. That God, the creator of the universe, that God loved you and me so much that he came. Yes, it was Jesus, but it was God. It was God in the flesh. He said, they're messing up so much, I've just got to come myself. And I want us to go to Philippians chapter 2, and it's verse 6 and through 8. And this is an amazing, amazing verse. You're going to see right here, it says, talking about Jesus, whom being in the form of God, did not consider it robbery to be equal with God. Okay, so God is pulling back the curtain and he's showing us his love. And he's showing us his love through coming himself in the person of Jesus Christ. And so it says here that he, being in the form of God, did not consider it robbery to be equal with God. So Jesus came. Yes, he was God, but his godhood, his powerfulness, the power to split the Red Sea, the power to, because all those people, you know how many times they blasphemed him and they said to him, you are the prince of the devils. Well, Jesus, in his power, if he was embracing his godhood, he could have just zapped them and said, none of you left. What if when they tried to throw him off the cliff and he just said, forget you, bink. I mean, that would have been the God kind of power. But Jesus wasn't holding on to that. He was holding on to the form of a servant. He was holding on to this humanness so that he could understand us. Oh, it's so magnificent. Look at the next verse. But he himself took on no reputation, taking the form of a bondservant and coming in the likeness of man. Now, why would God do this? Because he made us. Surely he understands us. But in Scripture, it shows us, and I'll show it to you in Hebrews chapter 2. It's just one of my most favorite scriptures. It's chapter 2, and it's verse 18, and it says about Jesus, for in him, in that he himself has suffered, talking about Jesus, being tempted, he is able to aid those who are tempted. He came so he could understand us. In Hebrews chapter 4, verse 15 and 16, it says that for we do not have a high priest who cannot sympathize with our weaknesses. So that means that we have a high priest who does sympathize with our weaknesses. How can he sympathize with our weaknesses? But was in all points tempted as we are, yet without sin. Every single way that you've been tempted or I've been tempted, he was tempted. And it says that he identifies with our weaknesses. He understands us. Oh, friend, this is the love of God, pulling back the curtain, showing that God is not just a God that created the universe, but now he's the God who came and wanted to understand man and wanted to be tempted just as you are and wanted to overcome temptation just like you do. He wanted to identify you. He wanted to have on flesh. It's a miracle. I was thinking about this the other day, and I was thinking about the virgin birth. Here's God. He's so big. He's so mighty. He's so powerful. He reduced himself to a tiny, tiny, tiny little embryo in the side, on the inside of the Virgin Mary. What kind of love is this? And then it goes on to say, in the Word of God, not only did he do that, but he humbled himself unto the cross, to the death, to suffer, and to take on our sin, and to take on our guilt, and to take on our sickness and our disease and our doubt and our hate and our anger and our jealousy and our confusion and anything that would come and bring destruction to the heart of man or to the body of the man. The love of God was reaching out through Jesus to rescue us from every sickness and disease and all sin. I'm telling you, friend, this is a powerful love. And as we're studying it, as we're talking about it, the curtain is being drawn further and further apart, opening up to us this revelation of God's love, not just out there somewhere, but to you personally. Jesus went so far as, of course, to die for us, to take our punishment, to take our sin. But then he went further and he gave us the Holy Spirit to live on the inside of us. His very person. When he was talking to the disciples, he said, I need to go, but I'm sending one to you and he'll be just like me. You didn't get some kind of junior size Holy Spirit on the inside of you. You got the very Holy Spirit, the one who is exactly like Jesus, deposited on the inside of your spirit forever and ever and ever, never to leave you. Oh, this is the love of God. You see, he loved you so much. He loved me so much. He wanted to be with me. He wanted to be with you. In the Old Testament, we see temple after temple. We see two tents because God wanted to be with his people. Then they built massive, massive temple worth billions of dollars because God wanted to be with his people. Then that temple was destroyed. Then here comes another temple because God wanted to be with his people. But he said, I didn't come to live in temples made of stone, but I came to live in your very body. In 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 19, it says, do you not know that your very body is the very temple, the very house, the very dwelling place of the Holy Spirit? And you are not your own, and you are bought with a price. You, if you're born again, you house within yourself the very person of the Holy Spirit. Just like Jesus. Oh, friend, he loves you so much. He rescued you. He doesn't want to be 1 minute without you, 1 second without you. So he came on the inside to live in you. Oh, it's amazing. And then his love even goes further. I want to show you this scripture because this is about our salvation. And it is in Colossians, and it's chapter 2, verse 15. And it tells you what Jesus did. And it's verse 15, and it's talking about Jesus. And it says, having disarmed principalities and powers, triumphing over them in it. And that word, disarmed, is like if you had a bomb and you didn't want it to go off and you did some twinking and you turned that bomb off, and that meant that that bomb was dead and it couldn't go off anymore. Well, that's what Jesus did to the principalities and powers. He defeated them. He disarmed them for us. And one more thing I want to show you about what he did. And it's also in Colossians. And it is in chapter 3. And it's verse 12. And it says, therefore, talking about you, as the elect of God, you're the elect of God. He's giving you your identity. You see, that's another part of pulling back that curtain. The love of God gives us the true identity, not what our parents said, not what maybe a spouse said, a friend, a teacher, a brother, anybody else, but what God says about you. This is the love of God. Therefore, as the elect of God, that's who you are, holy, you're holy, beloved, you're beloved. Maybe you've always wanted to be somebody's beloved. I think that's normal of all of us. We were made like that. We want somebody to love us. Well, there's one who loves you and me who will never, never change his love, never. You'll not disappoint him, and he'll pull back from you and not speak to you for 2 days. He won't give you the silent treatment. He won't start judging you and put up a wall like human love. No, his love is unconditional, and he'll continue to love you, and he'll continue to call you his beloved. That's the love of God. The curtain has been drawn, and we see that God so loved us that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And his life, not just that you would go to heaven, but that his life would come and live on the inside of you. Oh, this is the most amazing love. And that he put his Holy Spirit, his very person, right on the inside of you, because he didn't want to live a second without your presence. Oh, friend, I love you today. The love of God, it also says about the love of God that when that we got saved, that the Holy Spirit, when he came in, that he put the very love of God all over our heart so that we could love others. He's done everything. He's done everything. Now we see the curtain completely pulled back, and we can gaze on and discover more and more about the magnificent power of the love of God to us. Well, friend, I want you to stay with me because I'm going to be right back. And I want to pray with you and open our hearts even more to receive and acknowledge this great love of God.
God demonstrated his great love for you by sending his one and only Son, Jesus Christ, to earth to die for your sins. Not only did Jesus' sacrifice bring forgiveness of your sins, but he also made a way for the Holy Spirit to live inside you. Because of God's unfailing love, you experience freedom and forgiveness in your own life. In her life-changing five-part series, The Love of God, Denise Renner reveals how God pulls back the curtain to express his love for you, as she discusses how God's love is revealed, how God's love is displayed, how God's love is unfailing, how God's love is the great motivator, how God's love forgives and pursues. This five-part series is available in digital or physical formats starting at just $11. In addition to this series, we are also offering you Denise Renner's book, Unstoppable. In this powerful book, Denise brings fresh insight from God's Word about how you can overcome key hindrances that the enemy exploits to clog up your supply. Whether it's fear of man, rejection, unforgiveness, or other people's opinions trying to hold you down, you don't have to take it. Learn how to push past every obstacle and become unstoppable for God. You can purchase Unstoppable for $20. Don't miss this special offer. Order the bundle of the series, The Love of God, and the book Unstoppable by Denise Renner today. Call the number on your screen now or go to renner.org to order. Call or go online now.
Friend, isn't that amazing that somebody could love us so much that, I mean, we can not do the right thing, we cannot say the right thing, we cannot think the right thing, And instead of pulling back from us or building a wall between us, His unconditional love is constantly there. It's not changed. It doesn't move. It's there for us to just open our heart and receive that magnificent love and forgiveness one more time. Oh, that we would understand this great love that's been given to us. And I want you to either get the study guide of the love of God, and we're going to talk about the love of God being revealed, or get the series, the video series, and so that you can watch something and encourage yourself that way. But I want to pray with you because we're in this together. We're one family. I know I'm behind this camera, but I'm telling you, if you're born again, we're going to spend eternity together. And the love of God forever and ever is going to be revealed and revealed and revealed and revealed about this magnificent love that He has for you and for me. So much that He would come and die His very self and give His life for you and me. Father, we thank You for this magnificent love. Lord, just by faith, not by our feelings, but Lord, by our faith in the Word of God, we receive and we acknowledge this love, and that is the truth, and that You, Father, love us unconditionally. And Your love does not change from day to day, but always the same. Father, we thank You for this. We praise You for this. In the magnificent, wonderful name of Jesus. Amen. Well, I'm out of time, but I'm going to see you on the next program. If you've never received Jesus as your Savior and Lord, now is the time for you to experience a new life Jesus has to give you. Pray this prayer with me right now. Lord, I repent of my sin and receive You as my Savior and Lord. Wash away my sin and make me completely new. I thank You that my sin is removed and Satan no longer has any right to lay claim on me. I faithfully promise that I will serve You as my Lord for the rest of my life. Amen.
If you just prayed the prayer of salvation with us, would you please let us know by going to renner.org/salvation? We would love to connect with you. This program was made possible by the giving of the God Called Partners of Renner Ministries.